Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. Today we're going to be discussing topwaters. Drop us a comment below with your favorite type of topwater. This is one of my favorite times of the year. Guys, we have several topwaters that we like to use and we're going to introduce you to those. So thank you for joining us today here on Greenfish Nation. If you're not subscribed to the channel, if you would do so, we'd really appreciate that. Give us a thumbs up with that old like button. Also, don't forget to turn on that notifications bell. Thank you again for joining us here on Greenfish Nation today, and stay tuned for topwaters. I think those of you that have fished a topwater could probably say that's within your top 3 to 4 baits to fish. There's nothing more exciting to me than to see a fish blow up on a topwater and to give it that little 1 to 2 second pause and set that hook and then the fight be on. Guys, I like to fish a number of different types of topwaters. Basically, I've got them categorized in my boat. I have poppers, I have walking baits, I have the propeller baits such as buzz baits, the whopper plopper type baits, and also I have the torpedo type baits. The first bait I ever remember fishing as a kid on a topwater was a tiny torpedo and a baby bass. And man, I thought that was the only way to fish after I got that first bite. So guys, you stay tuned and we'll talk about these baits, colors, conditions, where, and how to fish them. All right guys, as most of you did, when I was a kid, started out fishing young. Like I said, my favorite and first topwater that I ever fished was a tiny torpedo. I've got a couple of them here. This was the first color that I ever fished. Tiny torpedo by Hedden. Little baby bass color, has a little propeller on the back. This is a great bait for ponds, rivers, or lakes. I like to fish that bait. That particular color has a white belly. So I like to fish it on a day where I've got some cloud cover. I like to throw it around just about any type of water, around laydowns, stumps, any type of vegetation, and anywhere from about 6 inches to about 6 to 8 foot of water. Especially along the back of a cove, it seems to work real good, that little prop bait. I just have had great experiences with it. I've got lots of confidence in it. On less cloudy days, I like to throw this little silver with a red back. They make them in silver with black, silver with blue. I've just got a whole plethora of them. This is the black back one. But on the high sky days, I like to throw something that's a little more realistic. I've even got a little bigger one here that's clear that works real well on those days. Another topwater bait that I've got a lot of fond memories with is a jitterbug. This is a good nighttime bait, the black, especially on a full moon. And then I've got another one here that's a little bit longer, a little larger size. This is actually not a jitterbug. This is it's called a Dalton Twist. It has a prop on the back of it, but it also has the spitting spoon type deal on the front that causes it to rotate like that. Makes a lot of commotion in the water. And then I've got one in a frog pattern that I like to try to fish around outside edges of lily pads and grass lines and down banks that have like a steep drop off. They'll have like some grass growing up on the edge and then it drops off steep. Those are a lot of good places to find frogs. Those all work good around that. Then the next kind of bait I've got, I'm pretty new to these. I've only got a couple of them. I've got the old whopper plopper. This is a kind of a perch pattern. I guess if you look, it's got the little fins and stuff on the side. I kind of throw that one in that color on the higher sky days where it's a little clearer weather. And then I've got this one here. It's kind of more vibrant. We've got lots of chartreuse and stuff on it. Throw this in dirtier water or on days that it's a little cloudier. It seems to work real good. Also like to throw that around the same types of cover in the same areas, around backs of coves, around stumps, laydowns, and weed lines. Neither one of those are weedless. They're gonna hang up on pretty much everything, but you can rip the grass out of them and then just keep working them. So. Our next bait is gonna be our walking bait. First one I ever had was a chrome blackback Zara Spook. You know, you kind of go back to what you believe in. This is a 4-inch two hook model. This is a spook here as well. I've caught lots of fish on this one in the last few days. This is a super spook. It's about 5 inches long. You see it's got three hooks. It's been working real well for me. It's kind of a like a shad pattern. It's blue on the back, kind of gold on the sides, and white on the belly. Another good color of spook is this kind of bone color with a black back. It's been doing real well as well, early and late. For those high sky days where it's pretty clear, I've been throwing this clear looking sexy shad. Been doing real well on it as well. Man, I tell you what, there's nothing more exciting than throw that thing out there, you know, 50, 60 yards from the boat and start walking that thing back, and one of them big old bass just come up and explode on it. Sure makes for a good time, guys. If you've never thrown a walking bait, you should try it. Next, we have our poppers. And I have a lot of different types, colors, shapes, and sizes of poppers. This is another one of my favorite ways to fish, especially with a top water. The first popper I had, it's gonna be the old popper. You just can't hardly go wrong with a popper. And again, this is in a bass color. I have a plethora of colors here, a plethora of brands. I've got some pencil poppers. I throw those occasionally. They're a little longer. They make a little different sound. These pencil poppers do. They don't have quite as big of a hole in the front, a cavity to move the water. They'll make a more subtle sound. They'll do a little more splashing and a little less popping. Where the popper, it'll make kind of a medium popping sound. And then if you really want to get with it, I've got a few of these chugger type baits, these hula poppers. They got a big mouth on them, and they really make a go floop whenever they go through the water, guys. So you guys check those out as well. Guys, another one of our ways that we like to throw on top, you can't ever forget the old frog, guys. You just can't hardly go wrong with a frog around heavy vegetation. Lily pads, grass, cover, laydowns, brush piles, flipping them, skipping them. You can't hardly go wrong with a frog, guys. We throw what we call our three basic frogs. We got the propeller frog, got the smooth front on it, little propeller in the back that goes around, kind of stirs up a little bit of wake as they're moving through the water. We have a popper frog, just like we discussed in our fishing frogs video. And then our last frog is just gonna be like a scum type frog that just has the smooth front on it. These are real good for skipping under docks and under limbs and around places that are not easy to get other baits into. I like fishing those, again, heavy cover, back half of the cove usually, or out on some edges of some main lake points. Just depends on what time of year it is. If I can find some cover out there, that's when I go with that frog out. Last but not least, got the old buzz bait. I've been throwing this one since I was in high school. I like throwing a 1/2 ounce buzz bait. I also like for my buzz baits to have this little flapper on there. I just like the way it sounds. It just gives you a little extra added noise and commotion in the water. I usually try to keep one of these white ones on there for clearer water. Also, clear skies. And then dirty water, and then cloudier days, I want to throw something with some chartreuse on there. I like to put a little shad imitator trailer on those. Sometimes I'll pull a skirt off and throw a frog on there as well, and it does real good around lily pads and all. But guys, that's topwaters. There is a bunch of them out there. There's so many that you could probably fill a boat up with them. All brands, shapes, colors, and sizes, and I'm sure there's some that I'm not aware of, but I appreciate you guys joining us today here on Greenfish Nation. I hope you've got a little bit of something out of these topwaters that we use, where we use them, what time of year. They're pretty good year-round, especially early and late. In the winter times, usually I try to fish them around midday when it's water's at its warmest, but other than that, it's early and late. So thank you guys again for joining us here on Greenfish Nation. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, I'd appreciate that you do so and tell somebody about us. Until next time, tight lines.